All right, it's rolling. 3, 2.
Chop Shop, this is what we do. This is the crew. You know how we say it and how we play it. What's up, y'all? As we always do, right about this time, this is a modified version of the Chop Shop. I'm your man, Mr. Rue, a.k.a. Buddha Blaze. This here is Mr. Marcus, better known as DJ Marky Lowe. And we getting it in for y'all the right way, the modified way. Just giving y'all a taste of the Chop Shop. We giving it to y'all with a little bit of flavor. So, I mean, the tournament, I'm going to be real with you, man. I haven't been watching too much of college basketball this year. I am a USC fan. And Kevin O'Neal, keep your head up.
Arizona fight, right?
Yeah, we got into a verbal match, a verbal sparring match. He had his wife in tow at the JW Marriott in the lounge at the bar. You know at the bar you having drinks, you feeling good. And you, when you with your old lady, you ain't going back down from a confrontation. So for those that don't know, Kevin O'Neal was on the bench with the Arizona Wildcats, wherever the hell they are. Anyway, he was supposed to be the heir apparent after Lute Olson stepped down. But Kevin O'Neal had a confrontation with the Arizona booster, and they had beef in the past. So you know when you catch somebody out, you know what I'm saying? When you catch somebody out, you catch them slipping. So they had little words between each other, and he had his wife with him, so he wasn't going back down. Mr. Marcus, who you taking in this tournament?
Who we got? Who you talking about?
Just the end of the March Madness. Anybody.
You got to ask KP.
The ones with the nice colors.
Yeah, I like the jerseys. I told KP to hook my brackets up.
In the NBA tonight, I'm going to talk about the two people y'all love to hate or love to love. Let's start off with LeBron James, King James. King James, D-Wade, and Chris Bosh, they took care of business tonight. They had it out with the Spurs. It seemed like they dropped 9,000 points on that ass, but they didn't.
They beat him by about 30, and it looked about that bad, dog. I mean, for real, man. Dwayne Wade was like, he looked like Superman, man. He was stealing balls, dunking, dishing shit off to LeBron. It was sick.
What about your man KB, man? Kobe Bryant, man. I mean, he sprained his ankle. He back tonight. They taking care of business against Orlando Magic.
Yeah.
Looked like they was getting some fouls. You know, I want to say this. Yeah, I'm a Laker hater. Paul Gasol gets these easy fouls. What you think about that hood, Guru?
He gets hacked a lot. He's a,
hey, man.
He's a thin guy, but he takes those hard hits, too. So.
Hey, man. He's a new Vlade Divac with that shit, man. He's a new flop, eh? He's a flop artist, man. I'm calling it like I see it, Chop Shop family. Y'all may not like it. All this Laker stuff ain't for me. I don't like it. This 76ers on mine. I'm going to give you another hot topic that's going on today. And I want my Chop Shop family to get back at me with this. Y'all need to subscribe. Y'all need to get at your boys. Tell us how you feel. The NFL, they propose an 18-game season. 18 games in one season. It's 16. Hell, it went from 14 to 16. Now it's 16. They're proposing 18 games. Tell me what y'all think. Y'all get back at your boys. Let us know. Like I said, this is the modified version. I'm going to let you know what's really good, man. I'm going to let my man, Mr. Marcus. Damn, boy, what you think about 18 damn games?
Man, see, that's where it's bullshit. See, you talk about the safety of these cats.
Yeah.
Then you going to put them out there for 18 games? 18 games?
They get hurt in preseason, goddammit.
They get hurt in preseason. But they want to stretch them out 18 games because they want to make the money back that they lost off the last deal. You feel like you stretch it out, you stretch the season out, and make more money. You charge higher prices because preseason tickets are usually cheaper, right?
Yeah.
You know, you kill off two preseason games, make regular season games. Now you done came up, you done doubled up. You feel what I'm saying?
Right,
you done doubled up your money. You know, because you done got rid of them bullshit preseason games with them sorry-ass prices. So, I mean, it's about money. And I don't blame these cats for honestly dissolving the shit and class action suing them. Because anybody that works for a union or is part of a union and you're going up against the company, when you do your bargaining, when they ask for shit from you, if you go, okay, I'll give you that, they're going to hit you with, well, look, you know, times are hard. We need that back because we need it to keep the company thriving and moving on.
Right.
When they take it from you, they don't give it back.
Right.
They'll tell you, hey, when things get better, we'll negotiate. But they ain't giving you nothing back. Once you give it up, it's done. It's over. You know what I'm saying? So I don't blame them for fighting and saying, fuck that. We ain't giving up what we already got.
Hey, y'all heard that. Once you give me the Fetty, bye-bye, Betty. No more, brother. Got to keep what I earned. Yeah. As Drew Brees put it, the forefathers of the NFL worked so hard for them to get what they got now, and they can't let it go. They can't give it back.
You can't give it back.
Hey, man, y'all tell us what y'all think. You sitting here watching. I'm vibing with you. I want some of that what you eating. I want some of that what you drinking. Share with your brothers from the Chop Shop. Let us know what's good. This is the modified version. Hood Guru, Mr. Rue, a.k.a. Buddha Blade, Mr. Marcus, a.k.a. DJ Marky Lowe. Chop Shop, y'all.